Hallo, liebe Zuschauer. Ich bin von kreativen Menschen umgeben, und zwar.
Hello, dear viewers. I am surrounded by creative people, both from Mainz, and we are here in the Novotel. Yes, you won't believe it, in a hotel room. On this side, I greet an actor from Los Angeles, Matthias Hues, and here, a producer who also lived in Los Angeles. Let's start with Matthias. You haven't been to Mainz in a long time. What is it like being here again?
Yeah, Fred, hello. We have uns ja schon mal in Los Angeles getroffen, ne?
Fred, hello. We've met before in Los Angeles. What, it's been 20 years, hasn't it? Now back in Mainz every year again. I really come almost every year for Christmas to visit my mother. She's 87 and we want to spend many, many more years, of course, here in Mainz at Christmas. And I look forward every year to come back to Mainz. A beautiful city, very different from America. We have here the beautiful churches, the cathedral square. Then we have the Christmas market, the old town. It's a fantastic, fantastic city. Also for me, this is really a holiday. I don't fly to paradise, I fly to Mainz.
Now you're here with your American wife. How does she like Germany and Mainz?
Auch fantastisch. Also für sie, sie würde am liebsten hier bleiben.
Oh yeah, also fantastic. She would like to stay here, you know. I mean, if you always live in California, we also live in Bali, in Indonesia, but Europe is really solid belt, you know, with a thousand of years of history and people and cultures, Roman, Frenchman, who wasn't here? And that has given us, of course, our history.
You're not only here on vacation, but you also are here to meet my friend Chris Peschken for a business talk. It's about a movie. What do you already know about it? Yesterday, you negotiated, you spoke a little bit about it.
Ja, wir haben schon viel darüber gesprochen, also wir reden auch oft über Skype, nicht? Chris Peschken.
Yes, we have already talked a lot about it. We also talk a lot on Skype. Chris Peschken lives in Switzerland, works at the UN, and we always stayed in contact over the years and have talked about this project for a long time. It's about refugees, but I would say Chris should talk a bit more about it. He's the author of the original story, has brought it all together, the writer, the director. Very interesting story, very hot. Interesting topic.
Let's switch over to Chris for a moment. You are in Mainz again. How do you feel here?
Mainz is interesting. After all, I grew up here. A lot of good things happened here for me and also a lot of bad things. But the older I get, the more I feel connected to the city and come back. We are here now for the fourth time and meet every time with you, as you know. I think Mainz is actually a beautiful city. Here I spent my youth, went to school. I think Matthias and I, we went to the same school. Ludwig Schwammschule. Yes, we have a past here.
Now to the future. You launched a new project. It's about refugees. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, first of all, we, my wife and I, we are TV correspondents at the UN in Geneva. We don't work for the UN. I don't want to look so bad. That's why I say we work at the UN, but not for the UN. Because the UN has, unfortunately, a relatively bad name, if you think about it. Many people, especially in America, say we do not need the UN. What do they actually do? They only talk a lot. I think the UN is already doing a lot, and without this forum, the world would look different. But that's another topic.
Hauptthema bei der bei den Vereinten Nationen, was wir täglich sehen, ist das Flüchtlingsthema.
The main topic at the United Nations is the refugee issue. And as you know, Fred, refugees are not so welcome now. And especially here in Germany, where everything politically slides to the right, or in France and Hungary and in Austria and many other countries, especially due to the refugee policies of the countries and the fact that suddenly people come who hide behind some headscarf and smell differently, speak differently, look different. You once said, if you drive in a bus here in Mainz, the bus driver no longer speaks German, but a foreign language. Or when walking through the city, you see a lot of headscarves. Those are the Muslim women. The whole landscape has changed. When I grew up here, went to school, we didn't see that. Everyone was practically Mainzer. And there was nothing else. Today it is more international and, of course, a lot of refugees. And I think that many people are so against refugees simply because of the fact that so many negative things are reported in the press about them. There's a saying, if it bleeds, it leads. So if there's a lot of blood in it, it sells better. And that's how the press works these days. And that's why you only hear the bad stuff, the negative stuff, so that people click on it, so that people look at it, so that people listen to it. It sells better than a good story.
Now, with your film, I think what I learned in the preliminary talks, it is a mixture. You use action in an interesting and also very profound topic.
Yes, exactly. The problem I see is that most people who reject refugees and asylum seekers and migrants have never met refugees, migrants or asylum seekers. That means they just repeat what they have seen and heard online, on Twitter and elsewhere. The bad news. And that is why they are afraid, because they do not know who these people are. They do not want them in their country. They want to stay here among themselves. And that means you have to first, I think, have a personal relationship. If you know someone, you have a different attitude. If you see someone and don't know who that is at all, you have a certain decals in mind or misconceptions until you know the person. Making a movie about refugees now, I think, wouldn't be so successful because people say, we don't want to have anything to do with refugees. So I was thinking, we are making a movie in which the refugee theme and the human trafficking theme are built in. But first and foremost, it's an action drama, so people can digest the theme. And to the people we show in the movie, our main characters, two of whom are refugees from Syria, a woman with her little child, we get to know the people, and by getting to know them, we have a different relationship with them. And maybe, I don't know if the movie can do that, but maybe one or the other viewer will look at that theme in a different way after the film.
To what extent is it important to such a film to act physically as an actor and to know the lines?
Yeah, so talking and running at the same time, that's of course the hardest thing. How can he act at all? I mean, he's so big, he's got muscles, but that's all nonsense. There's a good reason why Chris and I work together on this project. We want to explore the refugees, the individuals involved, whether good or bad, or whether it is a refugee. We want to bring these individual characters out and bring them closer to the audience, to get to know the motivation of the individual person better, you know? Of course we wrap this also in action. It's easier to watch. Otherwise, everyone falls asleep. And there's a lot of action even in real life. Our director, maybe you can say a few words about it, who also written the script.
That's a good keyword, the script. You've found someone very experienced, I've heard.
Yes, an old friend from America from 1995, Duncan Falconer. You can Google and read about him. Duncan was the youngest MI5 agent, British Secret Service, and later worked in private security. He protected people, also was a negotiator in kidnapping cases, and so on. And has been doing that for 30 years. And what a miracle that he never got hurt. He's still alive. Yes, because in his case, it's a dangerous profession. But he always has helped the studios in Hollywood and worked as a consultant when it came to action scenes and when it came to showing how to handle weapons and what a soldier does or doesn't do and the Secret Service agent and so on, Because in most movies, I would say that in 90% of the movies, especially the so-called lower-budget movies, the action and what the characters do is completely unrealistic. That means in normal life, the person wouldn't survive at all. So that someone goes through the movie for 90 minutes and kills 30 people and so on and doesn't get hurt, that's complete nonsense. And in our movie, we not only try to show sort of realistic action, but as Matthias rightly says, the characters, the development of the characters is the most important. This is true for the good one as well as for the bad one. Now, he plays an evil guy, but not such a decal evil. Personally, by the way, I always thought, and I know Matthias now since 1995, we met in Hollywood, yeah? I'm of the opinion that Matthias is underestimated, which means that he is somewhere fixed as a type, and if you are fixed in Hollywood as a type, then that's it. You only get these roles or you don't get any, so you have to live with that. To break out of this image is very difficult. And most of the roles you see are decals. There is no depth in it. The bad guy looks bad and is bad and does bad. The good guy looks good, is good and does good. But you don't know really why he is good, why he's evil. In our movie, we do what a well-known director once said. I think it was Sam Peckinpah who made all these big action movies. He once said, "I love all the characters in my movie, the good ones and the bad ones. And I want to get to know the story of the good and the evil. Why did he become evil? Why did he become good?" And that gives the film the depth, the humanity, and of course, the same goes for the refugees we show. Those aren't those who come here because they like it better and don't need to work so much and trying to just make a nice life for themselves. Fact is that most of them don't want to leave their country at all. Most of them want to stay there. They have a house. They live there. They grew up there. They don't even want to go to another cultural area. How can one think that people like to travel 5,000 to 6,000 kilometers across the Mediterranean Sea, running the risk of drowning there, and most of them do, to go to a foreign country where they don't even speak the language, suddenly trying to set aside their life for a certain time or to completely rebuild it? Who likes that? Yes, of course, people say then, there are those who do it because they can earn money here. To me, these are not the classic refugees who flee because there is war in their country.
If someone from Germany, maybe from Mainz, wants to become an actor and just buys a ticket and goes to LA, is that a way?
Well, hard to say. It can be. It doesn't have to be. It used to be a bit easier. Back then I didn't have to have a green card, no residence permit. I mean, you could stay 3 months, that was fine. Nowadays you would have to be a known actor already with a lot of references so you can get a residence permit at all and make movies here. Dass du überhaupt eine Aufenthaltserlaubnis bekommst und dort Filme drehen
kannst. Kriegst du nichts ganz aufregend, was ist? I'd say it's very simple. If you go to Hollywood today, Matthias has been there for, what, 20 years or more?
30.
Okay, 30 years ago. If you go to Hollywood today, then bring money.
Welcome home.
If you don't bring any money, then maybe you'll end up on the street. We recently saw a documentary about people living in the trash can in Hollywood who came there to make a career in the music business, and it was very dramatic. Only very few make it. But when you arrive with money, money is gladly taken, but you get nothing back. Hollywood is deadly. I mean, Matthias does that for so many years now, and of course knows God and the world.
Well, I haven't personally met God yet, but I pray diligently. There's no joke now, I'm a Catholic, you know?
was die Leute nicht wissen. Und Chris und ich, wir haben eine unglaubliche Vergangenheit.
What people don't know, Chris and I have an incredible past in Hollywood. Our story alone, that has crossed over the years, the roads we had to take had been so stony, bumpy, full of adventures, fast-paced, frustrating. There aren't enough adjectives to describe. You can't imagine that we're standing here in front of the camera in Mainz and talking as if nothing ever happened.
Ich kann mir vorstellen, wir stehen hier so locker jetzt in Mainz vor der Kamera und reden hier, als wäre nichts passiert. Aber es ist eine unglaublich schwere Reise.
But it's been an incredible difficult journey, which I can hardly recommend at all, because you have to be really prepared to suffer. It's not as glamorous as people imagine. And when Chris says people live on the streets, really like that. It's almost impossible these days. Sure, everything is possible. I mean, you shouldn't stop anyone from pursuing a dream because it's possible. But like Chris said, you have to somehow bring the potential, either with money or have to have a lot of time. It's a life decision.
A good final word, I'd say. So for me, a Hollywood career is probably over, dear viewers. If you are really interested in visiting Hollywood as a vacation destination, I can recommend it. I would like to thank the producer, Chris Peschken.
But you would have a big chance in Hollywood, Fred.
As what?
Well, as what you did the other day.
As Santa Claus, you mean? Yeah, I'd have to glue on a beard like yours. But yours is real. It's real, dear viewers. I thank Matthias Hues. Google the man. Quite great stories.
Oh, yeah, I almost forgot. Very important. I've written it all down. 30 years in a novel. Memoirs. It's published soon, and it's called Shirtless in Hollywood. Without a shirt in Hollywood. Because I practically built my career with fighting and muscles. Very interesting story for people to see how it all came about, or how to become a Hollywood actor in the first place.
Where can you find it? On the internet? On Amazon. Shirtless. Without a t-shirt?
Without shirt.
Without a shirt in Hollywood. Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, dear viewers, that is it. I'd like to thank Chris Peschken and Matthias Hues again. I'm jealous of him anyway because he has such a great figure. I wish you all the best, and I will see you again sometime. Yeah!